Previously on Cinema Therapy.
I think it took me to my mid-20s before I was really able to be okay with somebody not liking me.
Everybody's talking about my tight pants. I got my tight pants on.
They did so much good work. The editing is top-notch. The lighting is brilliant. There's energy. It's just, oh. I was really blown away by this movie.
And now, the emotional conclusion of The Greatest Showman. Yes, Alan is going to cry.
Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist, and I love movies.
I am Alan Seawright, unlicensed but professional filmmaker, and I need therapy. And we are joined today by a fabulous guest, Jahannah James.
Hello.
Hello.
Here we
go. By the end of it, you will be jazz hands. I promise.
Okay. We'll see. We'll see if that happens, Jahannah.
I feel like I've been trying to push this boulder over for years to get him into like a jazz hands type of person, and I think I just needed I just needed a co-pilot. Great colors in this film. Great use of color.
Absolutely beautiful.
Pops. Simple and planned.
I really, really resonate with her character with Charity. Won't sell
the sea, yeah.
They're safer. Why is that?
To follow all of her morals align with mine in a relationship. All I want is someone that includes me. I'm not really interested in the material or financial things you can give me. Just be there.
Yeah.
So I felt that. I was like, she's me.
Well, and that's... I resonate with this because I fear that I have many times put my career in a place where I've done this to my wife. And it's easy to do. It's not just, you know, a thing that happens to filmmakers. It happens to anybody who's a workaholic.
But... I love how he's not there and he's clapping somewhere else. That says everything.
He's clapping another woman.
Yep.
Oh.
But just this, he's chasing this dream because he came from poverty, and so he's trying to resolve his own insecurity by being the biggest, the most successful, and the most prestigious. Like, he had huge financial success, but he wants to be the most prestigious, and he misses, like, what he really needs is in front of him the whole time.
Yeah. It's that classic screenwriting technique, right? What the character wants and what the character needs are two different things, and he has to learn how to want what he needs.
Yeah.
And he's in the middle of being in the wrong place right now. And Michelle Williams is just so brilliantly...
People hating on Zendaya from the crowd because she's a person of color. Well, it's all an versus Rebecca Ferguson. Classy, elegant white lady, so she has our acclaim. Walk in a tight room with you. Ooh, ooh. This gets criticized for being a simple film, but there's a lot of brilliant symbolism in the filmmaking.
I think it gets criticized because the symbolism is easy to understand.
Yeah.
And for, you know, intellectual critics, that can be like, oh, it's so easy to understand, it's so simple, anyone can get it. And it's like, yeah, everyone can get it. What's bad about that? Also, why isn't Michelle Williams a much bigger star? She's fantastic.
Yeah, she is.
Yeah, her voice.
Nope, don't you put your head on his shoulder.
No.
Don't do it.
The clever thing about this movie is that it shows how easy it is to develop that kind of infatuation with someone and how complicated it can get. Like, Hugh Jackman's character isn't a bad man. He's just in this really messy place, and
I
hate him and I feel for him at the same time.
Well, I see that a lot in therapy with clients and things, is people rationalize and justify, like, I haven't crossed this line yet, therefore this is fine. It's under control. It's totally, I'm not getting too close. It's not romantic. But the moment we start putting our affections outside of our partnership, outside of our marriage, things that should be reserved for the marriage go elsewhere, is when we're on a slippery slope, you know?
Yeah.
And that's, and when you talk about him being a good guy, like, that's something people don't understand. We're in a very snap judgment type of society. And what I see, what I see in my therapy office is people who make mistakes that they never thought they were going to make.
Yeah.
You know? And we're all just people.
Yeah.
We're all just broken and we all up.
Yeah, and it doesn't excuse making the mistake, and it's, I mean, this really resonates with me. Jahannah, I can see you're getting emotional. It's making me emotional. This story really resonates with me because of the nature of my job, I have to spend a lot of time in close emotional relationships with people. My job is to direct actors and bring them to an emotional place. Yeah. And that is inherently a very emotionally close job. You have to trust each other. You have to have that kind of relationship. And Jahannah, I know you've acted before.
Yeah.
You can get, it's very easy to get very close emotionally with your director, right?
Yeah.
I've given you the world, haven't I?
And it's also very easy to mistake that emotion that you're sharing with each other in a professional setting for personal emotions.
I should go.
You know, in my profession, I've seen it destroy so many good relationships that because people from an innocent place were doing their job and then it led to making a mistake. And that doesn't, it doesn't excuse the mistake. It doesn't mean it's right or okay, but it's so understandable because I've seen it and it's happened to so many of my friends.
Yeah. Any, like in the, this industry is a tough industry because you create very intense little bubbles for periods of time where the worlds get mixed up because you're making a movie of a different story or you're playing a character. And it's really tough. And I've been an actor and you've got to be in a world or you're doing a play or you're in a movie and you've got to be pretending and pushing these emotions. And it can get a bit confusing. And I've seen and heard so many that loads of my theater friends and my movie friends have made very bad mistakes in this industry. And I don't think it's just this industry. Obviously, it can be happening in an office. It happens anyway. It's just a human thing.
It happens a lot in therapy, honestly.
It happens a lot in therapy. It happens in emotionally
Not my therapy.
I believe those are the words of a scoundrel, Mr. Barnum.
Right. It happens a lot in emotionally intense and physically intense professions, right?
Yeah.
Where you're spending either a lot of time together or in a really intense sort of pressure cooker environment together. You know, film just happens to be, at film and theater happen to be one where you're spending, you know, 10, 12, 16 hours a day together in an intense emotional pressure cooker environment where we have to get a lot done, but we also have to share these feelings with each other. So that all, it all makes sense. But yeah, you know, what you were saying is it's easy to make those mistakes. And that's, it's, I don't know. It just gets me.
Now, if you're looking for more of this episode and more Jahannah, because there's so many wonderful insights and hilarious jokes that aren't going to all make it into the YouTube cut, Alan says that he cries on the internet for money.
I cry on the internet for money.
He's not sure how he feels about that.
It's, look, we're all just dancing monkeys for the internet.
That
it's
makes
fine.
Me the pimp of your tears, actually.
Oh, boy.
We invite you to check out our low-cost membership site where we have extended director's cut episodes of our show with no commercials, as well as relationship courses that I have created especially for you to help you with conflict resolution, communication, family, dating, parenting, blended families, the works. That's all there on our membership site. And so check out the link here or here. There's also a bunch of other perks, but that's where you'll find out more information. Can we talk about safeguards?
Let's do. That is a great idea.
And I mean, I don't want to just dive in and be like, I've got all the answers because I don't have all the answers, not by a long shot, but what are your, for both of you in your industry, what are your safeguards? Like what helps to.
Yeah. What are my safeguards? It was a lot harder when I was younger and I was new to it. Now I feel like if there is anything that you feel uncomfortable sharing with your partner, whether that be a story or a text or I believe in like total transparency and you know, we could swap phones for the day and I'd be relaxed and he'd be relaxed. And I think if there, anything happens that you don't feel comfortable about in your gut, listen to your gut. And if because it's telling you something. And if you feel like you have to look a certain way for a certain person, like, that's just a little signal to yourself to go, okay, let me just analyze. Because obviously being attracted to other people isn't necessarily, you're human.
That's natural,
that's not a bad thing. I can find other people extremely attractive. But just find your boundaries and find what you're comfortable with, and it'll be different in different, like my parents, they would tell each other all the time who they fancied. And I found that a little bit weird, but that was normal in my family for my dad to be like, oh, she's on the list. Or and my mum being like, oh, you know, if I got a second husband, it would be him. But that was their healthy.
Right.
So, and for other people's relationships, it's like, no, we never, ever fancy other people. Don't even look at my Instagram, bae.
I'm just realizing we need to use the word fancy more in the States.
We really do. We need to fancy people.
Oh, do you not use it? Oh, we say fancy. Oh, fancy him. Fancy
him. We use it like you look fancy, but not I fancy you, which I think is a very charming way to
say it. It's much better.
Hi, I really fancy you.
Fancy you too.
Can we go out?
Sure.
Tonight?
Perfect.
Okay.
It's really interesting. When we started dating, she was not clingy. And that was one of the things that attracted me to her the most, was I could disappear on a film for 3 or 4 days and like not, she wouldn't get upset that I hadn't called or texted because I was like in my movie zone, right? And that was something that I found, you know, that I was really excited about. And now I have to be the one to initiate, and I, you know, call or text 2 or 3 times a day, basically no matter what I'm doing, just so that I don't get in the wrong headspace.
Yeah.
It's for me more than it is for her. I'm sure she loves my stupid snide remarks about whatever I'm eating for lunch. I'm sure that's the highlight of her day? Question mark?
I spend a lot of time in the company of emotionally raw, vulnerable women.
Sure.
Right? And what helps the most on my end is, one, I'm not obnoxious about it, but I broadcast enough that I'm crazy about my wife that it's not even on anybody's radar.
Yeah.
You know? My screensaver on my computer is a family picture. My phone is her. The second thing is I have really strong boundaries. One time a therapy client told me that I looked handsome that day, and I said, mm-mm. And she says, what? I'm like, I thank you, but that's not something you can say to me. And she looked very insulted, and she says, I can't pay you a compliment. And I said, you can tell me I'm a good therapist. That's a little harsh, but it was a very strong line.
Yeah.
Now, those of you who are calling me Dr. Snack in the comments, that can absolutely continue.
Because it should continue. He is a snack.
Because we don't have a close emotional relationship. And my wife actually thinks that's hilarious. She loves it. I'm like, look at what they're saying. When we posted our new moon thumbnail when I'm shirtless.
You're shirtless.
And I was super nervous about that, by the way. I'm like, I'm like 40 years old and I sit in a chair and I don't hit the gym as much as I want to. Because if I'm not working, I'm like with my kids, you know?
Yeah.
And turns out dad bod is the second sexiest body type after actually sexy. Because dad bod says he works for a living. Jahannah's not buying it.
No, I'm nodding along. Dad bod is, it's totally up there. Like, I would prefer dad bod over something super chiseled because I just feel bad, you know? taking my top off. No, are you kidding? Not with those abs.
That's the thing. When you have dad bod, people feel comfortable with themselves. That's why I do it.
Yeah.
I do this for all of you. I want you to love and accept yourselves. That's why I do what I do.
So we're going
to
be looking at From Now On. Jahannah, why are we looking at From Now On?
Because this is my favorite song of the whole movie. And also the most emotional one. Like this guy, Hugh Jackman. He's not called Hugh Jackman. What's he called in the movie?
P.T. Barnum.
Phineas. This is like Phineas. He's realized that he's messed up. And it's all about kind of redemption. And I've been in relationships where I've been cheated on. And I've also been in a relationship where I was the perpetrator and I was the cheater. And I've been on both sides of it. And this song, I think, just like encapsulates all of that about when you realize like what it is that you've nearly lost and could you get it back? And... I'm going to need a tissue. I'm going to need a tissue.
Felt that winter wind blow cold.
It's not just
Hugh Jackman has one of the best marriages in Hollywood, though.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's amazing.
Like, he shouts about his wife all the time. Debbie. Deborah.
Yeah.
My Deb.
Well, and they met in the theater, didn't they? From that room. I think they did. What
remained? But he almost burned all these bridges, not just with his family, but with them. If you know, pursuing the fame, and not just the fame, but the prestige.
Pursuing the prestige. He already had the fame. It led and the success. Back. And he just kept wanting more.
And what I've noticed is the people who have the power to give prestige and take it away tend to be blowhards, and their opinion doesn't matter anyway.
Yeah.
You know, what this matters are the real people and the real connections. And he's neat. Like, if I'm going to feel good about myself, then these people have to accept me, and these people have to give me the accolades. And here he's talking about, I've been in the presence of kings and queens, the politicians praise my name, and he's like, it really doesn't matter. I mean, it makes me, Jim Carrey said something one time, he says, I wish everybody could be rich and famous. So they can realize it doesn't make you happy. It
doesn't do anything. Someone else's
dreams. Yeah. The pitfalls
of the man I be. Decency makes
it's us happy. The illusion of fame. Anybody famous that I've interviewed a lot of celebrities, and they are all normal people.
If you could set up the teleport between one place and another, where would that be? Like your bed to Five Guys, or
our bed to Five Guys?
Yeah.
What?
Where, like for me, I would do my bedroom straight to a to Five Guys. That's to where
five,
I would.
What's a Five Guys?
It's like a burger.
Place.
Oh! No, not Five Guys.
Oh, you're like, well, you hey, whatever you're into. I mean, if you're into that, that's cool.
Yeah.
There's just an illusion that they are
special or different, or you know.
Yeah, like they're not gods. They're just a bloke on the TV.
Yeah.
Cool.
No judgment.
I mean, that's
yeah, no
fun.
Judging.
I mean, sounds good.
Not
I mean, not
shaming.
That I'm in. I mean, are you asking?
That's the way you're all.
No,
you know, talented, but you know, everybody's talented at something.
3 months ago, we were a YouTube channel with 3,000 subscribers.
Right.
And now we have fans.
Yes.
And when we respond to their comments...
I was one of them!
And we're fans of you.
Dreams
and you're
can
fans
happen,
as well,
people!
But,
look where I am!
But, like, people... we respond to their comments, and they're like, oh my gosh, they responded! And we... First of all, we love it. And we're very flattered.
Extremely flattered.
But there's no one less, like...
deserving?
Or less, like, oh my gosh, like, we're a couple of dads. And...
we're just some blokes.
Just some blokes. How are you? Your jazz hands better be coming now.
Oh, they're coming.
I love the wolf boy. He's tight. It does get...
I tried to learn this dance. It is so hard.
It is so hard, right? Physically, I'm looking at this and I'm just exhausted. Like...
look, like that move there. That move there, I nearly dislocated a hip.
Doesn't it feel a little Pentecostal?
It does, for sure.
Like someone should be handling a snake up in there?
Absolutely.
They are all moved upon by the Holy Spirit. Look at them go. That footwork is...
the physicality in this dance is fantastic. The thing that blows me away about, you know, really talented stage and just musical theater actors is the ability to do this insane physical stuff while singing and carrying a tune and emoting.
Yeah. Yeah.
All of it at once. It's magic.
I love that she gives him his hat.
What can I say? We're blessed.
And then he does the Tom Cruise. Here he is doing the Tom Cruise. He's as best as he can. Which is actually a pretty good Tom Cruise impression. Just running, running.
He's running. He's literally running for his life there. He's realized none of that matters. It's his wife. Like when the pubs and the bars open after COVID.
That's although fantastic.
Better be. Oh, they're getting together.
It's not a bad thing to come out of a coma too.
Yeah, you could wake up to Zendaya and probably feel pretty good.
Any day.
I mean, I'm sure he has cotton mouth, but she doesn't care because that's love.
That is true love.
Well, that's me. Got anything else? Everyone's looking. They don't care. Let them look. They're in love.
Jahannah, you are a gift. Thank you.
Why didn't I have a tissue? I feel like this scene gets me because I imagine if anyone was going to come and apologize to me, I would want them to say the lyrics of this. Let this promise in me start like an anthem in my heart. That way. Oh.
I never wanted anything but the man I fell in love with.
Let this promise in me start like an anthem in my heart.
He felt he meant that.
However big, however small.
It's hard to sing act.
It is really hard, and these these two are just crushing.
It's really hard to sing.
From now on.
I love that they hug instead of kissing.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, because they're friends since they were kids.
I mean, they do kiss, but they don't lead with that. That's a good shot.
I am a huge believer in crying. I think it's so good for you. I think everybody should do it.
So am
Men,
I.
Men, women, children. I think you should encourage your kids to cry. I'm so thankful for you, Alan, because you're like a man, you're a dude, and you're out there on the internet crying your eyes out every week. And I think it's brilliant. Because I really struggled to cry. As a kid, my mum would say, like, you have a heart of stone. Nothing makes you cry. And now I'm a big crier. I'm making up for it. Totally. Now. But it's good. It's a really good thing. And I imagine not being able to cry.
Emotions need to be felt.
They do. Yeah. They do. And it's, maybe not quite to the same extent as you. I definitely cried a bit as a kid. But it's a lot more now.
I think when I started dating... Is this around the same time that I learned to cry, unfortunately? Boys made me cry.
I was going to say, dating will do that. You know, I look at this story, and I love at the beginning, it's all pomp and circumstance. It's everything you ever want. It's everything you ever need. This is the greatest show. And then at the end, it's just him there in the theater with his family watching the ballet recital, and he sings it softly. There's a lot of dreams we can chase, and we should chase them. There's a lot of things that give us fulfillment or give us joy. But if we're neglecting... the people in our lives and we're neglecting the connections, you know, that is something that we will regret.
Absolutely.
And if we have to trade, this is my opinion. I think our family, our friends, our loved ones is the better play. It's the better pick. That's my takeaway from Greatest Showman.
Yeah, I agree. I don't think there are many people who are lying on their deathbed thinking, boy, I wish I'd made an extra $10,000 on the stock market or... Boy, I really wish I'd spent more hours at the office. But I think there are a lot of people who lay on their deathbed regretting things they didn't do in relationships.
Yeah.
And regretting things that they did to their relationships by, you know, making the mistakes that P.T. Barnum makes.
Yeah.
And that Zac Efron's character makes. Yeah, there's a lot to be learned. And also the tunes.
They're bangers.
Also the tunes. I think this movie should be called People Mess Up, But It's Okay.
I think people would line up for that. People mess up, but it's okay.
People mess up, but it's okay.
It's okay. It's okay.
Jahannah, I want to draw your attention to something. Alan just did jazz hands for you, and I don't think you saw it. This
is me. I missed it. Welcome to the theater.
So we want to thank you for being on the show today. Where can people find you? Because your stuff is hilarious.
Oh, I'm all over. Jahannah James. I'm on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Just everywhere at Jahannah James.
Awesome. Yeah, hilarious and informative. Your series on ancient archaeology and stuff is fascinating. I've been watching them with my kids, and they love you.
Yeah. Very, very
thank
cool.
Thank you. Yeah, as this little side hustle, I'm just fascinated with ancient history. That's my big passions are like movies and ancient stuff. And I decided to make some videos on it. And that's my passion project. So you can watch that as well if you like ancient dudes.
And you heard it here first. We're going to make a female-driven Indiana Jones movie starring Jahannah James. This is a thing that's going to happen.
Indiana. Yeah, Indiana James.
Indiana James.
Awesome. Tell them about our socials.
We have some social medias. You can find us at @therapy_cinema on Twitter and Instagram. We're on r/cinematherapy on Reddit. We're Redditors now. And we're on Facebook and stuff too.
So until next time, every night I lie in bed,
the brightest colors in my head.
This is me. Wrong song.
And
watch movies.
It's everything you ever want. It's everything you ever need. And it's here, right in front of you.